Hi everyone. Hi Cali School family. You all probably know who we are, but just in case, I'm Nick. And this is the Shanghai Quartet. Weigang Li on violin, first violin. Honggang is brother on viola. And our newest member, Angelo, on second violin. Over the winter break, we actually traveled here to China, where we're also teaching, in addition to being in residence in Montclair State, at the Tianjin Juilliard School. And we recently gave a concert, actually on Beethoven's birthday, December 16th, and it included three Beethovens, one of which we'd like to present to you guys for our Wednesday at now 1:30 concert. This piece is very dear to our hearts. Actually, we recorded it twice, once for the Delos label and once for our Japanese label Camerata, which we recorded the entire Beethoven Quartet series for. Would you like to say anything about 59 too?
Well, it's we probably performed at least a couple hundred times this piece, and it is one of the masterpieces. It's from Beethoven's middle period, along
he wrote 16 and a half quartets. So this is quartet number 8, so it's smack in the middle.
This particular quartet is in a group of three quartets, and they were commissioned by the Count Razumovsky. This is actually 59 number 2, and each of these three quartets has a Russian theme somewhere buried inside of it. And we'll ask you guys, I'm sure you'll hear where that, or maybe you won't, you'll have to figure out where that Russian theme is located. I'll give you a hint. It's not in the exterior movements, but there's a Russian theme in every one of the three Razumovsky quartets. This is Opus 59, number 2. It's in E minor. The first movement is in typical sonata form. It's pretty fast. I think it's marked Allegro something. Second movement is a beautiful slow movement played with sincerity and expression. It was one of the first slow movements I learned with the quartet back in 2000.
Beethoven, in one of his letters, described this movement that himself was lying on the top of a hill on a nice weather at night and looking at the stars.
Very touching. The scherzo and trio is very interesting because you may hear something in there sounds Russian. But what's interesting, at least compositionally, is that he elects to repeat. A normal scherzo and trio, or normal minuet and trio, is basically A, B, A form, meaning that you play the minuet, and then you play the trio, and then you go back to the minuet. But what Beethoven, of course, who departs from all normal conventions and conventional compositional techniques, he elects to actually, you play the scherzo, then you play the trio, then he has you repeat the scherzo and repeat the trio again, and finally back to the scherzo. So you'll hear the scherzo three times, which is highly unusual. And actually he did that a few more times, at least in his later quartets. The last movement is a romping, super fast movement. You'll see a lot of virtuosity by Weigang. Hopefully you didn't make any mistakes. I don't know, it's a live performance, I'll let you know. As I said, we gave it on December 16th, and we hope you enjoy it.
On Beethoven's 200th birthday.
250th birthday.
Yeah. It's a senior moment. And we look forward to seeing you next week. You'll probably see us on campus already when this concert takes place. But all the best, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Thank you.